That case, what we have to do? Let here again we have a bearings, and there is a restriction that we cannot keep our balancing mass in the same plane of rotation of the unbalanced mass. So, in that case, we have to choose some other planes, means we have to take some other plane other than the rotating plane of mass M. Let here we are taking the balancing mass in some other case, in some other plane. In that case, here let balancing mass is B, acting at a certain B distance from the center line. So, what we have? If two planes are there, certainly there would be some distance. Let here the L is the distance between these two planes, and the forces acting are away from the shaft, means due to the balancing mass, it is acting away from the balancing mass in the same plane or radially outward. And for the other case, due to the unbalanced force, it is acting away from the center line in the same plane as rotation. So, for the balancing, what we have done? Because the single mass is there, if we are balancing it with the help of the other plane, in that case, if we are taking m r omega square, if the shaft is rotating, is equal to whatever the balancing mass, the distance or radial distance is there from the axis into the omega square, that is a centrifugal force that is acting. So, in this way, as earlier we have to balance it, in that case m r is equal to B B. But here one thing is also there, another entity, that is the force. Here we have a one force, here we have another force due to the balancing mass. If they are equal, then they will produce a couple, means force multiply by the distance, that is L. So, they will produce a couple, and this couple will act, or it must be bearded by the only the bearings. The problem will still be the remain the same as the earlier, means we have a F multiply by L. We have a couple and this would be an unbalance. So, we have unbalances there, and again it varies with omega. That is, if the shaft has, let 15,000 rpm, means 15,000 times in a minute it is varying, and finally it must be bearded by the bearings or whatever be the foundations we are applying. So, finally, earlier we have a force, unbalanced force, now we have a couple, and it has the same variation in speed, means that is varying with the same RPM, and finally it will again create the wear tear and noise vibration at the ends or at the bearings. In that case, we have to take care, means we have to balance the couple also, means whatever be the torque is acting or moment due to these forces are there, it must be balanced. So for that we are taking another plane, means more than one plane is required to balance the rotating mass. So in that case we have to take the another plane. Another plane means here let we have a M is there at a distance R, radius of rotation, and at the end there is a bearings the two planes. It is better if the space allows we can take our planes as A and B side. So we have a plane A, we have a plane B. Here in A at a certain distance we can keep our balancing mass B1 and another that is a B2. Here the distance, let here the distance is B1, small b1, and here the distance is small b2. So in that case the force may be balanced, means whatever be the balancing mass opposite to the unbalanced mass has been kept, they may be balanced as equation m r omega square is equal to b1 small b1 omega square plus b2 small b2 omega square. So in that case we can say that mr is equal to b1 small b1 capital B1 small b1 plus capital B2 small b2. So this one is a final equation we can say for the balancing a unbalanced mass by keeping the balancing mass opposite to that one, opposite sides of the plane in which the rotating mass is there. Another thing is important, again the couple would be there, so it must be balanced. In that case we have point A, we have a point B, and here let C is there. So we have ABC is there, according to that ABC we can take a moment about any point. So first of all let us take a point A. So the moment about A or moment about B or moment about C. So we have a three equations, moment about A, moment about B, moment about C, any one of the moment may fulfill our condition. So, in that case, if we are taking the moment about A, in that case, the distance between the planes must be known to us. Let here we have a L1 is there. L1 is a distance between the plane of M and B1, and similarly L2 is a distance between the plane of M and the plane of B2. So, if we are taking the moment about A, in that case M R omega square, that is a force, multiply by L1, it is acting in a anti-clockwise direction. So, as we can see that from the A, the force is acting radially outward, force multiply by the perpendicular distance, that is L1. So, the force multiply by L1, it must be equal to the force by B2 into B2 into omega square into distance, that is L1 plus L2. So, the L1 L2 is there. So, the total distance is multiply by the force that is outward, and this force due to B2, it will make to rotate into the clockwise direction. So, we have taken the moment about A. Similarly, if we are taking the moment about B, in that case the F1 or into L2, this is nothing but the above force multiply by L2. It is acting as a clockwise direction. If we are taking the moment about B, means F1 into L2, that is acting into the clockwise direction, and this must be equal to the force due to the B1, means B1, capital B1, small b1 into omega square, and the distance is remain the same. The distance between the planes B1 and B2, that is L1 plus L2. And similarly, we can do for the C also. If we are taking the moment about C, in that case B1, capital B1, small b1, omega square into L1, that is equal to capital B2, small b2 into omega square into L2. So, from here what we have observed, that if we have to balance the unbalanced mass not in the same plane in which the rotating mass is there, in that case we have to take two planes. It may be either side of the unbalanced force plane. So, we have taken the left and right side of the plane in which the force is rotating. After that, the force was unbalanced force has been equated to the balancing forces due to the B1 and B2, and after that we have taken the moment about the A, B and C. Only any one of it is enough for our calculation. So, in that case everywhere we have taken the omega square, and this omega square, if we neglect that one, the simplest it will become more simpler. As you can see on the screen that in the first equation we have observed that m into r is was equal to b1 capital b1 small b1 plus capital b2 small b2. Similarly, the other equation in moments we can say that m r into l is equal to capital b2 small b2 into l1 plus l2. Similarly, here everywhere we can neglect or we can cancel out the omega square terms. The another case is there in which there is a restriction that we cannot keep our balancing mass as in one side. In that case we have to take the balancing mass in at one side of the unbalanced mass. For that, how to do that one? Let here it is a center line. In center line we are keeping our bearings at the ends. Let here this one is a plane of mass m rotating at a distance r from the center line, and the available place is in one side, means left hand side of the rotating plane. Then we have to take the two planes. Let here one plane is here and another plane is somewhere here. So the balancing mass, how to keep that one? It must be in such a way that if another is, means if balancing mass is somewhere here, then the another would be opposite to this two. So here what we have observed, that we have a balancing mass one